In this section, we're going to take a look at markup based on cost. The success of a retailer depends on many things, including knowing the customers, controlling costs, and hiring great people. It also depends on the price at which products are offered to consumers. In this chapter, we use the language that people working in retail use, including cost, markup, and selling price. So let's take a look at the terms used in selling. Cost is the amount paid to the manufacturer or supplier after trade and cash discounts have been taken. Shipping and insurance charges are included in cost. The selling price is the price at which merchandise is offered for sale to the public. Markup, sometimes referred to as margin or gross profit, is the difference between the cost and the selling price. These three terms are often used interchangeably. Operating expenses or overhead include the expenses of operating the business, such as wages and salaries of employees, rent for buildings and equipment, utility, insurance, and advertising. Even an expense like postage can add up when making thousands or millions of shipments. Net profit or net earnings is the amount, if any, remaining for the business after operating expenses and the cost of goods have been paid. Income tax is computed on net profit. So here we have the terms used in selling, markup, and managers mark up the cost of an item before selling it. For example, assume a backpack costs a business, say $176, and that it is marked up by $53 before putting it up for sale. Determining that markup can be based on the cost. Since manufacturers often talk about inventories in terms of cost, they often use the phrase markup on cost. We also have markup based on selling price that retailers use. We'll start with based on cost. And here's our formula for markup. It shows that the selling price is the sum of the cost and the markup. The combination of these items account for the selling price. The markup is the sum of our operating expenses and net profit, as you can see. So let's take a look at some problems, and we've abbreviated the formula for markup. And to solve these, we are often given two of the values in the basic formula. We would need to know cost and markup to solve for selling price. We would need to know cost and selling price to solve for markup. And likewise, if we were looking for cost, we would need to have markup and selling price. So here we have an example. They're giving us a cost and selling price and asking us for the percent markup. Because these are based on cost, that determines where our 100% or our base quantity is. Markup based on cost means 100% goes here. Filling in the information given, we know the cost is $15 of this item and we know the selling price. Well, if we have the selling price and the cost, we can't find the percentage directly, but we can subtract and find the markup, which is the difference between the selling price and the cost. So we have a $5 markup. Now what we have is a part looking for a rate and know our base. Solving for a rate, we take the part, $5, divided by the base of 15, convert that value into a percent, so we have a markup rate of 33.3%. In this next item, very similar to the last one, we're given the cost and the selling price and asking us for the percent markup. Using the foundation formula, and because this is based on cost, that determines where our 100%, our base, is falling. We can put the values that we know cost and selling price, and again, we can't directly find our percent markup until we know the markup amount. So taking the selling price minus the cost gives us our markup amount. Now we have a part looking for the rate and know the base. So to solve for rate, we will take part divided by base, convert this into a percentage, and answer with a markup rate of 94.4%. In this problem, they're asking us to determine the markup and the selling price for a Casio watch if the cost is $1,750 and the markup rate is 20%. Well, here's our foundation formula. It is a markup based on cost. That dictates where 100% falls. The problem is telling us we have a markup rate of 20%. And if you follow the formula, 100 plus our markup rate gives us a percentage for our selling price. The only other piece of information right now we know is $17.50, the cost. But knowing our base and a rate, we can find our markup, the first question they're asking. And then once we have that, we can move on to answer the next question. So we're looking for a part, the actual dollar markup amount, given the rate and the base. So we will take base times rate. We have a markup amount of $3.50. And we have one of two ways that we can solve for the selling price. Since we know our markup, we could add those two, as you see here on the slide. Or we could use our rate and our base and calculate our selling price as well. In this next problem, it tells us the cost of some socket wrench sets from Taiwan is $10.36 per set. Harbor Tool decides to use a markup of 25% on cost. Find the selling price of the socket wrench set. Using our formula for selling price, and given that the markup is based on cost, that dictates where the base 100% falls. They're telling us a markup of 25%. Following the formula, adding those percentages tells us our selling price is 125%. They're asking us only for the selling price in this problem. Plugging in the other piece of information that's given, which is the cost of this socket wrench set, we can now jump to finding the selling price, treating it as the part, given we know our rate and our base. So to find a part, we take base times rate and gives us our selling price. In this next problem, Olympic Sports purchases Spalding basketball system at a cost of $180 each. If the company's operating expenses are 6% of cost, and a net profit of 7% of cost is desired, find the selling price of one basketball system. Here's our formula for selling price. They're telling us that we have a markup that's not only of 7% of cost, that's telling us where our base is going to be, but they also want to be sure that the markup includes enough money to cover their operating expenses. So the combination of those two percentages, 6 plus 7, gives us 13% markup, and adding the 100 plus the 13 gives us the percentage of the selling price. They're asking us for selling price. We have a rate. We need one more piece of information, and that's given in the problem. The cost of this system is 180. We now have our base. The number that's associated with 100% is the base. We have a rate, and we can go forward and solve for the selling price. And here we have a graphic showing how that selling price comes together. The markup margin or gross profit is the sum of the operating expense, which that was the 6%, and then the net profit, the 7%, as stated in the problem. So doing the calculation, we are looking for a part, so we take base times rate, and this system will cost a customer going into this store offering this $203.40. In this example, a laptop computer has a markup of $45, which is 32% based on cost. They want us to find the cost and the selling price. To help us organize the given information here, we're using our formula for selling price. Because they're telling us that the markup is based on cost, that dictates where the 100% or our base falls. They're telling us that the markup is 32%. Using the formula, we can add our percentages together to give us a total percentage of selling price, and they're telling us the dollar amount. So in this example, they're asking us to find the cost. In other words, we're looking for the base, the number associated with 100%. We know a rate, we know a part. To find the base, we take part divided by rate, and here our 32% expressed as a decimal is 0.32, so part divided by 0.32 gives us a cost of $140.63. We can then add cost plus markup to determine the selling price, or we could use the percentage that the selling price is, looking for the part, which is the selling price associated with that base price that we found, our cost, $140.63. So here's our base times the rate that's associated with the selling price to come up with the selling price. And you can check these using both methods to make sure that the answers agree with one another. In this next example, they're asking us for cost, they're giving us a markup dollar amount, and telling us that the percent markup on cost is 50%. They're also asking for selling price. So similar to the last problem, we're using our foundation formula for selling price. Because it's markup on cost, that dictates our base 100%. The percentage markup on cost is 50%. Adding those together gives us 150% for selling price. We know the actual dollar amount for the markup. And again, the number associated with 100% is the base. So if we're looking for base and we have a pair, and by pair I mean we have a rate and a part, we can solve for the base. Part divided by rate, rate expressed as a decimal, results in a cost of $108.76. And to solve for the selling price, you can either take the cost plus the markup, or here on the slide it's showing us using the percentage as our rate, looking for the part given the base that we just found, you can take base times rate to come up with the selling price.